Hello students, how are you? Today we are learning our fourth lesson, Be Reading Maya Bazaar. Observe these awards. You can see National Film Awards, IFA Awards, Nandi Award, Dada Saheb Phalke Award. Why and to whom these awards are given? Think once. See, Nandi Awards, Filmfare Awards, Saima Awards and National Film Awards. All these awards belongs to film industries. Once in a year, these awards will be given to the best performances. Different award categories. See here how many categories are included in this. These categories will be awarded in the ceremonies. Here is a video clipping for you.
उस पुलिस वाले को क्यों मारा रे?
किसी को मारा तो पुलिस ढूंढेगा, पुलिस वाले को ही मारा तो तुम्हारे जैसा डॉन ढूंढेगा।
क्या चाहिए बे तेरे को?
दुनिया।
Hope you enjoyed this video. Did you observe how the boy was performed his action? This is called the direction and the dialogues which were written by the dialogue writer and the screenplay all together will make a scene perfect. Based on these type of actions, awards will be given. Each year, the best categories will be awarded. These are selected from only in that particular year. See these pictures. Here is the best hero, best heroine, best director awards. We'll see the history of Indian cinema. In the beginning, the silent movie era. Cinema came to India on July 7, 1896. Lumiere Brothers Cinematograph Films in Bombay. In 1899, Harishchandra Shakaram Bhattavedekar, two short films, The Rustlers and Man and Monkey. The first entirely Indian made film Raja Harishchandra, considered the father of Indian cinema, produced and directed by D.J. Phalke, released on May 3, 1913. Early India film history. Dhundiraj Govind, Dada Saheb Phalke, 1872-1944, he is known as the father of Indian cinema. His films depicted Hindu gods and promoted Indian independence from Britain. Swadeshi, indigenous movement sought independence through boycott of British goods. This led to rapid growth of Indian film industry. Here is a scene you can see. That is the scene from Raja Harishchandra. It is most influenced film in early Indian cinema. Here the birth of Indian cinema, how it was took place in those days. Bal Gangadhar Tilak admired movies and supported Dada Saheb Phalke in his attempts in creating a Swadeshi cinema. He was the first in Marathi press to carry film reviews in his daily newspaper Kesari. Dada Saheb Phalke released his epochal feature film Raja Harishchandra on 3rd May 1913, and thus he was called as the father of Indian cinema. This was the first motion picture. We can see the clippings from this picture below. Let's see some information about Dada Saheb Phalke, father of Indian cinema. Actually, his name is Dundiraj Govind Phalke, but popularly known as Dada Saheb Phalke. He was director, editor, sound recordist, special effect person, and master of many other techniques in making a film. Here's some more information for Dada Saheb Phalke. He began his career as a small town photographer in Godhra, and he directed India's first full-length feature film Raja Harishchandra in 1913. He made 95 movies and 26 short films. He specialized in lithography and oleograph. He also worked for famous painter Raja Ravi Verma. Dada Saheb Phalke Award is one of the most prestigious awards of Indian cinema. Finally, India Post released a postage stamp to honor him on 13th April 1971. After the history, here we can see different eras in Indian cinema. Observe these black and white movies. The name itself says it's a black and white. So, whole movie is in black and white. After black and white pictures, when technology was developing day by day in those days, gradually Eastman color was used in making films. This Eastman color is a trade name used by Eastman Kodak for a number of films and processing technology with color motion picture production. This was introduced in 1950. It was one of the widely successful single strip color processes. And in these pictures, when we can see colors, when these pictures are released in theaters, the people were much excited to see their favorite actors in colors. But these colors are not exact colors which we can see in our surroundings. Modern movies. By using this advanced technology, we see actual colors, clarity in pictures, and also clarity in sounds. Now the directors are making wonders by using different types of technologies like VFX, 3D, digital cinematography, drone camera, cloud-based technology. These films are blockbusters nowadays, and many films are praised all over the world. From beginning of Indian cinema to till date, all movies were in online pool. In this online pool, Telugu film Maya Bazaar has topped the pool conducted by IBN Live to find out the India's greatest film till date. Almost every big name of Telugu, Tamil and Kannada film industry was associated with Gayatri Venkata Reddy's film Maya Bazaar, which was released in 1957. Be it cinematography or be it music, this film was a pioneer in every sense. The theme of the film threw a new light on the events of Mahabharata. Before going to the lesson, here we have glossary VFX. Visual effects shortened to visual effects and then to VFX. The vicinity, the area around a particular place. Reverberate, have a strong effect on people for a long time. Repeat verb, all that a performer can do. Advent, arrival. Array, an impressive collection of things. Indignation, a feeling of anger. Sarcasm, a way of using words that are the opposite of what one means to make fun of somebody. Be ready, Maya Bazaar. K.V. Reddy's Maya Bazaar has been voted as the greatest Indian film in an online poll conducted by a television news channel. The poll was conducted to find out India's greatest film till date on the occasion of 100 years Indian cinema, and the people chose Maya Bazaar over other Indian classics. The film is considered one of the enduring classics of Indian cinema and was christened as a landmark achievement in Indian films, cinematography, art direction and VFX with the available technology during that time. The following is a review on the film when it is celebrated the Golden Jubilee in 2007. Maya Bazaar Forever. 50 years ago, director K.V. Reddy, or for that matter, producers Nagi Reddy and Chakrapani, would not have imagined that what they were unleashing when they decided to make Maya Bazaar, a bilingual in Telugu and Tamil. Their finished product hit the screen in 1957 to become a landmark movie in the Telugu film industry. It became a hit not only for the sterling performances of the star ensemble that it had, right from S.V. Rangarao, Savitri, NTR, ANR and Gummadi, but also because K.V. Reddy was in full control over every frame of it. Persons behind the greatest movie. There is little else one could expect when all-time greats like Marcus Bartley, cinematography, Ghantasala, music, M.L. Vasanthakumari, Leela, Sushila and Madhav Pethi, playback, Gokhale, art, Pasumarthi, choreography and Peetamaram, makeup, got together to weave magic around an episode from Mahabharata, Shishrekha Parinayam. However, the greatness of Maya Bazaar, about which much is said and written, is not just because of these facets alone. It is a tribute to Telugu culture, language and customs of the land. The film was watched repeatedly soon after its release because people identified every character of the film with someone they knew in their immediate vicinity, and the audience still do the same now. The dialogues written by Pingali Narendra Rao, as well the lyrics, were the same that the people were hearing or using their conversation every day. If not, those became a part of Telugu life thereafter. Shishrika's Ne Ghatotkacha's Manadi Sodara Prema became immortalized as much as Suryakantham's Anta Alamalame Kada which has become a way of life in greeting people. As for songs, Ahana Pelliyanda still reverberate in marriages, and Vivaha Bhojanamu is yet another must. An entire repertoire was added to the Telugu dictionary by the film. Take for example, Talpam used for denoting a cord or a pen, where Telugu is using Gilpam as an antonym of it till the movie's advent. Nor did anyone tell so emphatically till Ghatotkacha that Evaru puttinchukunte matalu ela pudtayi, and hence if friends are to be called Asmadiyulu, then enemies could be termed Tasmadiyulu. Will anyone forget the expression Veyendira Vediko Veerathadu? No exception to Hi Hi Sodara Hi Hi Nayaka. The story itself is woven around the love of Shishrika Abhimanyu, with Krishna and Balarama having difference of opinion over it. Their wives too take sides, as is inevitable in any family. To introduce the theme, the director uses a magic box, an equivalent of a TV screen, which displays whatever is dear to the viewer's heart. Shishrika naturally sees Abhimanyu, and Balarama gets to see his Shishya Duryodhana on it. His wife laps up the sight of an array of jewelry, and the audience laughed heartily because they knew that someone back home was equally attached to the riches. When Balarama curtly tells his sister Subhadra, "Agadalu agaityalu naku panikirau," when he was confronted with the latter indignation at his decision to separate Shishrika and Abhimanyu, women folk among the viewers sighed, recalling their own tribulations in the hands of such brothers. Frame after frame impact viewers with similarities. The greatness of the director lies here. He successfully reduces all characters to ordinary mortals, displaying all the follies of human beings except Ghatotkacha and Krishna. And then he injects into the Yadava household a Telugu atmosphere full with its simile, imagery, adage, sarcasm, and wit. The result, a feast for the eyes and soul. That is Maya Bazaar for you. Mind you, this is a story of Pandavas and Kauravas with Yadavas pitching in. But one never sees the Pandavas throughout the film. We only hear of them. If any Annarai ask you to suggest ways to teach Telugu culture, just ask him or her to introduce them to Maya Bazaar first. Further, if they seek to know about their uncles, aunts and cousins back home, bring in their names. Look, this is your Balarama. Any better way of doing it, then onwards, it's all lahiri 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 lo. After finishing the lesson, here are some comprehension questions from your textbook. First one. You have read the review of the film Maya Bazaar. List the things that the review focuses on. Answer. Reviews based on the below. Selected as the greatest Indian film, VFX, theme which was introduced by a magic box, and director K.V. Reddy, cinematography, music, art, Telugu culture, and finally dialogues. Based on these things, the Maya Bazaar film review was taken. Here is the second question. Do you think this review of the film is positive or negative? Substantiate your view. Answer is Yes, Mayabazar received positive reviews from critics. The greatness of director lies here. He successfully reduces all characters to ordinary mortals, displaying all follies of human being except Ghatotkacha and Krishna. Third one, what made Mayabazar a landmark film? Answer: the film is considered one of the enduring classics of Indian cinema and was christened as a landmark achievement in Indian film's cinematography, art direction and VFX with the available technology during that time. Fourth one, why is Mayabazar watched repeatedly? Answer: the film was watched repeatedly soon after its release because people identified every character of the film with someone they knew in their immediate vicinity, and the audience still do the same now. Fifth one, what is the central theme of Mayabazar? How have the Telugu speakers settled abroad looked upon Mayabazar? The central theme of the film Mayabazar is the marriage of Seshareka and Abhimanyu. If any NRI asks you to suggest way to teach Telugu culture, just ask him or her to introduce them to Mayabazar first. Students, here is a open-ended question. Just you have to find out the correct answer from the given below points. The purpose of the review is A. to give an account of the stars of the film, B. to establish the element of Telugu culture in the film, C. to help NRIs to understand Telugu culture, D. to praise the producer of the film, E. to advertise the film. Students, please find out the purpose of review is. Hope all of you understand this session.